Hi, everyone. Welcome and thank you for joining us. My name is Roy. I lead product measurement at AppsFlyer. These are the core products of AppsFlyer. Today with me are also Niv, which leads audiences and incrementality products, and Yevgeny, who oversees product strategy as a whole within AppsFlyer. Today we're here to talk about protected app signals. This is a recently released feature by Google Sandbox. It's extremely exciting, and we're going to talk about what it is, what it means for advertisers, and what it means for ad networks. So thank you for joining. Without any further ado, let's just deep dive. I think for me to start, actually, in the end, this feature is here to solve the most basic problem that is being created when identifiers are going to be taken away. So presumably when Google advertising ID is going to be deprecated, one of the most important features, capabilities of today's, the ads industry is the ability to do cross app targeting, which is interest based. All right. So a lot of the current ad network optimization is based on cross-app contextual experience and ad serving based on interest-based. This is different from intent-based, where some search options are mostly on intent. But interest, in order to have interest-based advertising, you need to know what the person is actually interested in. And that's a hard job. Assuming you're only relying on what the user is doing within the context of your app. If you were to know what the user was doing in the context of other apps or anything else in the world, it would make the job much easier. And today, this is done primarily using identifiers, all right? So assuming identifiers are gone, that's going to be a very hard job to do. And this is what Protected App Signal is here to solve. So I will hand it to Niv to explain a little bit more on what Protected App Signals is actually.
Thank you, good to be here. So I think the most easy way to describe it would be that the OS itself is going to be the facilitator for the information and the context, as Ray said, coming from either the advertiser side or the sell side in order to perform these future ad auctions. In similar to a protected audience, it does have first and foremost a way for SDK entities to delegate this mechanism to any other entity that is not on device. But essentially, there will be a placeholder on the device itself for the ad network to provide the signals they need for future ad auctions. And also it demonstrates how the sell side at the time of the auction can provide the data and within a trusted environment to conclude what's the winning ad. Now for, we have recently got a few questions around, we already have the protected audience. Is it exactly the same? So I just want to pinpoint some differences between the two. First of all, would be the use case, the actual use case. Protected audience is defined to answer the retargeting or re-engagement use case. So as an advertiser, I want to target my own user on a third-party app. So for example, I evaluate this user and next time I will be able to reach them on a third-party app, I want to show them a 10% discount. Now, in the case of the new Protected App Signals API, this answers the UA context. As an advertiser app, I want to advertise my app to a user I don't know yet, but I need ad networks to target users based on context. Otherwise, I will not have the option to reach relevant users to my app. This dictates also the entity that is in charge of this flow. In protected audience, that would be the advertiser itself. In protected app signals, this would be the ad networks providing the signals based on their own data or data they're getting from a third-party app. Also, this means that an app signal that the ad network or the DSP provides can be built of data from multiple apps. So when it's time to make the option, they could base their data on multiple signals coming from multiple apps and crunch them together into one decision. And another important factor is that all this logic happens in real time, unlike protected audience that requires ads to be added in advance. For example, in protected app signal, the ads are provided at the time of the auction to be very similar to how it operates today. And I will conclude with the fact that actually these two flows work together coherently. So at the end of the day, for the publisher side, they want to present the best relevant ad, and this could be either an ad that is based on a protected audience, or it can be a user acquisition ad or any other ad based on protected app signals. And Yevgeny, how would you say, or how impactful this is going to be for advertisers and publisher alike?
Thanks, Steve. I think, at least as I see this proposal, I'm looking at from the eyes of how the world operates today versus how this will look like in the whole context of the sandbox with all the included changes. And like you said, from the publisher perspective, right? So whoever's serving the ad would like to generate as much revenue possible. This will be by facilitating an auction like today. It could be the best yielding ad, could be a retargeting ad. It'd be a user acquisition ad from one of the apps. Other could be other types of ads, and the flow here that is very similar to today. From the advertiser perspective, you are as a marketer, you're engaged with a couple of marketing channels. You cover the whole retargeting aspect within the user acquisition sphere. You're engaged with 5, 6, 7, 8 marketing channels. With the goal of acquiring users. Each channel has its own capabilities, its own perspective on how those users should be acquired. And as an advertiser with each one of those marketing channels, you are set up in a way where you are used to engage with each of those channels by sending specific events that you think are relevant for that channel, and or you care for yourself. This would be if you're trying to optimize toward a specific event, or if you're trying to hit a certain ROAS goal. But whatever it is, between you and that marketing channel, you have this bridge where you are sending all those signals for different use cases. Today, that relies on the identifier, obviously. And in the context of the protected app signals, basically, that relationship is transferred to the device itself, where each advertiser will be sending to its marketing channels the signals that they're used to, maybe more, with how that marketing channel will define that to be implemented on the operating system itself. Today, that is managed by the MMP, obviously. And with that information, today, each ad network calculates that on their servers, builds whatever they can in terms of understanding the best contextual ad to serve to that user. In this new world, based on this proposal, the ad network will run what it is usually running on its servers on an ongoing basis on the device itself. Basically, all the advertisers that network works with will be reporting on the operating system level on the device itself, creating that feature set that marketing channel is used to operate. And in the process of picking the best ad, it will now be able to pick that without having the same setup as today, but in a similar abstract approach, where basically each advertiser shares what's important for the advertiser and for the channel. And the channel now is able to target users better. And it, you know, if I take a step back here, we have a new set of capabilities released here. You know, we have topics that helps marketing channels receive marketing contextual signals about what are the interests, the topics, as it's called here, of that specific user. We have audiences. Did that user, protected audiences API, did that user engage with something that that specific advertiser is interested in? And we have app signals where now we understand much, much better about that specific user without any PII, privacy-centric, because what most marketing channels are after, not all, is just serving the best ad to that user without necessarily knowing that user specifically. So this really streamlines and simplifies a lot of these challenges, and even to a level that I believe it unlocks new capabilities to many marketing channels that I'm not used to operate this way. So creating a level playing field, but at the same time, I believe it will also increase performance on the monetization side and from the marketing perspective to really find those users better across all channels. And that is all facilitated on the device itself, other than the auctioning process itself. But what the marketers really care for, what the marketing channels really care for, and what the publishers really care for, actually is streamlined in a better way. Obviously, it's a completely different approach, but it solves the problem maybe even in a better way. So that's my take.
Yeah, that's a great take. So I think if we look at things in the bird's eye, and kind of going up higher and in terms of Sandbox in general. If you look at Sandbox and if we put SDK runtime aside for a minute, and if we're looking at the attribution API, and then we have topics, and then we have protected audiences API, and now protected app signals as part of protected audiences API, but I think it's really like maybe a fourth product here. I think these are really good solutions that obviously the industry will have to adapt to. It's going to change everything. But I think until this moment, the industry was feeling that measurement will be okay. Perhaps remarketing via protected audiences API will be okay. And there was a great doubt slash concern about the targeting capabilities, which are one of the most important drivers of the ability of today's advertisers to actually make their business work, right? If that breaks, then perhaps their business breaks. But I think this is a really good step towards better optimization and better targeting capabilities, cross-app, interest-based. So I think this is a really good step, and I hope this session made it clear on what it is and what it's supposed to fulfill. And thank you for joining us.